Hey guys, it's Craynesia, and in today's video, I will be reacting to episode 7 and 8 of Black Bullets. It's gotta get started on episode 7, and 3, 2, 1, go. Nope, it's Tina! It's Tina! It's Tina! I don't like this. She's not dead. She's not dead. No. This is best child we're talking about. Of course she ain't dead. But Tina will be dead by the end of these two episodes. Mark my mother up in words. Smile, I can. Like, oh my god, that just like saves everything. Like, ah! Go save my child, please. Oh. Oh my god. Your honeycomb is showing, baby. Like, the biggest thing is we still need to know who the fuck is Tina's master. Like, seriously. Yes, she could have easily killed Andrew if she really wanted to. I mean, hell, she did that shit to the police officer. So it's like, okay, why not Andrew? This fucker. by yourself, though? You still want to try? Just be careful, though. Don't do anything reckless and stupid, but too late, you already are. Seriously, you cannot hesitate with that child. That's not a child anymore. She hurt and you. After that, you were never a child again to me. Like, mm-mm. So we know a name, but like, what does Professor Ron look like? Madame, do we have to burn down the building? I mean, it's because of the fact that she still secretly cares about him. Not even secretly, she does, and she doesn't want to kill him. But Yeah, but she's gonna wait until one moment where you fuck up. Do you think that's the only one that she's gonna fucking have? Fuck this. Then where is she? I mean, which is obvious because she shot at the top floor, but. I mean, well, what if it's a trap? It's a trap. Come on now. I mean, look, she's a bad guy. Oh. Tina. She's behind you. Oh! And this one can evade attacks. It is. because of that, she's blinded by it. Okay, now just handcuff her, take her the fuck in. I mean, yeah, we can still kill her if you want to, but I don't think he's gonna do that to you, though. Because he cares. Oh. No, you haven't lost everything. You can still start anew. Yeah, it might be a long time and you're gonna be in prison, but sure. I mean, save Tina. Oh. I hope so.
True. God, she's okay. Thank God. And she's okay. Because, whoo, God. For a moment, I was like, damn, they really about to kill Tina off. Even though Tina is in this opening and such. Because, you know, even though you are in the opening, you can still be killed off. Trust me. Like, oh. Whoa, thank God. She's okay. And she's hired. And now we have another member of our family, which is so fucking cute. Like, oh my God. Just, I'm happy. I'm so happy. And thank God that asshole is gone because fuck him. Like, oh my God. Just you. Assholes. Assholes. I hate them. I can't stand them. Like, why do people, whether it's real life people or even animated characters, like, why the fuck are you such a dickhead? Like, oh my God. What is wrong with people to be such mean towards others? Or especially whether it's like class, personality wise, or anything. What the fuck gives you the right to be mean to someone? Like, damn, even if they're like the nicest thing. But like, there was a moment like credibility. I was thinking like, yeah, he's gonna kill Tina. He just, I think if he did, Rentaro would have had remorse for it because Tina. I mean, yeah, still children dealing with this situation. So come on now. I mean, children. I hope this isn't me now, like, now Andrew and Tina are gonna fight over him. I mean, it's already worse, kind of, with, like, Andrew, Kisada, and, I mean, even though Kisahata really has, like, no she has feelings towards him, but, like I said, almost very similarly with Enju and Iwase and, Bakuman, Kisahata is really mostly in love with her work. She's an independent bad bitch, which I love and such, so hence why she is one of my personal favorite characters of the show. But, I mean, there are moments between them. It's cute little moments, and then next thing you know, Enju comes in like a mother effing third wheel and be like, bruh, like, sit down. Go to the side, child. This is not about you. But go ahead and pause the video, and I'll see you guys in 1 second for episode 8. Alrighty, episode 8 in 3, 2, 1, go. I love how I got a freaking email. I can't speak about Pinterest and shit, and then Uber Eats. You know. Now this is already opening up, not too good. Of course, this dude is about to die, right? The hell is that? Guess area. Well, you definitely. Oh. It looks more like spit, but Well, I told you he was gonna die, though. Seriously? Tina. Tina wouldn't wake up for this. And besides, you got good leadership skills. You're really good at talking and such. So yeah, you can do this. No pressure. Hands. Good. God, she's so precious. Psh, ow, that hurt. That would be fine. I love pizza. And pizza's the only fucking thing she can make you want to eat the shit out of it. Where is Tina? Poor baby with her wording. Yeah, why not Andrew? Jesus Christ, oh my God. Tina? I really thought he would have took her home with her, with him. But at least, like, stop to go get her sister. Seriously? Of course, I mean. It's okay. Damn, like, cool. But if Yusuke dies next week, well, we ain't gonna know until next week, but, you know. You gonna end it right there, aren't you? That is a bitch move right there. Who ends it right there? Oh, come on now. That's so fucked up. But the match, like, it was short, but it was sweet. They got it done quickly. We moved on. Ish. That's it. What's about to happen next? Like, anything, truly any fucking thing. I love the fact that, you know, Renzato took Tina out for her to see, like, different parts of the, like, you know, Tokyo. Like, oh my god, like, that was sweet. It was a date, but I mean, whoa, 35,000 yen on a damn dress. I mean, was it he ain't buy it, but was it worth it to see her in the outfit? Yes, but still, I wouldn't buy it. Like, that's too much money. I mean, I've spent, like, clothes overall, I've spent a lot of money on clothes. And then especially if I want, like, a couple of shirts and stuff. A girl can spend her money on that. But, like, oh, but the fact is that they only have a couple more days before these Geshaya come and destroy Tokyo. Like, it is a lot to, you know, right on this small little group that Rentaro is making. And it's like, okay, is everybody really gonna put their differences aside, work together? I mean, Yuzuki and her brother seem like, yeah, they will, but, like, who else, if they get on, you know, with this small little group, would they put their differences aside? Who fucking knows? I mean, seriously. And then, but the fact is that he also helped that little girl who was blind, because of the fact is, like, at first I was thinking someone, like, gouged her eyes out and such. No, she put lead in her own eyes. Like, oh my god. And the fact is that her mom hated her and abandoned her and just did that to herself to protect herself in a way. But still, like, you feel so bad because of the fact is, like, she thought that she got money. No, people are assholes and be like, no, here, take this, what is assumably money, but it's not. And I feel so bad for her. And so I hope her and her little sister are okay. But it would have been nice if, like, Rentaro would have took him in. But I get the fact, just like, yeah, you already got two little girls running around your place. I don't think you want more. But the fact is, she can't really, like, the girl who was blind, she can't do anything. She has to rely on others. So it is really sad. And then it makes you wonder what her little sister could have possibly done. But because of the fact is they didn't show her, we'll never know. But really, these last two episodes were very good. Yes, that moment in this episode was very sad and hurtful. Yes, seeing Tina get shot in the previous hurt just as damn well. But, like, oh my god. I can't. My heart. Too damn much. But other than that, guys, that is my reaction view towards episode 7 and 8 of Black Bullet. If you guys enjoyed it, please give me a like. It really helps me out. Also, subscribe to my channel. I make videos every single day. Join the Master Squad. And, of course, I will see you guys officially all next Friday for Patreons. And next Monday for everybody else for episodes 9 and 10. Bye, guys!